Children, in the series of class 4, today we will read and enjoy the poem that has been given in Unit 2, Noses. And the poem has been written by Aileen Fisher, and the poem tells that nose is a funny thing. Now in the poem we will come to know how is nose a funny thing. Let us read and enjoy this poem.
Noses. Let us read and sing this poem. Here we can see a girl looking herself into the mirror. Yes, I looked in the mirror and looked at my nose. Is the funniest thing the way it grows? Stuck right out where all of it shows, with two little holes where the breathing goes. Just see how funny in this poem how funny our nose has been told. I looked in the mirror. The girl, she looked into the mirror and then she looked at her nose, and it's the funniest thing the way it grows. And she says that it is the funniest thing the way it grows, stuck right out where all of it shows. She says that it is a funny thing that where it has been stuck here, with two little holes where the breathing goes. And with two holes, this is more than a funny thing. This is the funniest thing ever happened. I looked in the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin and the start of my hair. She says that when I looked into the mirror, what is mirror? Mirror is a glass which can reflect your image, which can reflect your picture to you. When she looked into the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin, you can see your chin. The girl looked into the mirror, the end of her chin, and between there, the start of her hair. There she looked into the start of her hair also, from where her hair started. And between there, between the end of the chin and this hair, the head and the chin, she means to say the start of the hair and the chin, between these two places, there is a funny thing called nose. This one is the funny thing. She says this is very funny. Isn't much space to spare with my nose, like a handle sticking there. And she says that it is like a handle. Nose is like a handle, she says. If ever you want to giggle and shout and can't think of what to do it about, just look in the mirror and then, no doubt, you'll see how funny your nose sticks out. Now, she says if you want to giggle. Giggle means when we don't feel like doing something and we have to do it, or we don't feel like a thing to happen and it goes. Then we feel bad. We feel irritated. That is the feeling of giggle. We feel like shouting, right? And can't think of what to do it about. Just look in the mirror and then, no doubt, you'll see how funny your nose sticks out. The poet is that she says, when you feel like shouting, when you feel like giggling, when you feel irritated, just go into the go and look into the mirror and you'll find a funny thing on your nose. We'll read this poem again and read it in a tune, and so that you may learn it with proper intonation. I looked in the mirror and looked at my nose. Is the funniest thing the way it grows, stuck right out where all of it shows, with two little holes where the breathing goes. I looked in the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin and the start of my hair, and between there isn't much space to spare, with my nose like a handle sticking there. If ever you want to giggle and shout and can't think of what to do it about, just look into the mirror and then, no doubt, you'll see how funny your nose sticks out. So this was the poem. These are the new words given to us. Mirror. Mirror is a glass which reflects your image. Funniest is the thing. So funniest is the superlative degree of funny. Funny is something which makes you laugh. Breathing. Breathing is the process of inhaling and exhaling the air into your lungs through your nose. Sticking. Sticking means to get pasted somewhere, to paste something somewhere. Giggle. Giggle means to, what does giggle mean? Giggle means to get irritated. Now, reading is one. The question answers, why does the poet feel that the nose is a funny thing? Why? The poet feels that nose is a funny thing because she thinks, why is it has been sticked here? on the face. Why is the nose important for you? Nose is very important because it helps us in breathing in and out. Does the child in the poem like her nose? Why do you think so? No, she does not like her poem, like this nose. In the poem, the girl, she does not like her nose because she thinks that it is the funniest thing. Describe a few funny things that you have seen. Do they make you laugh? What does features mean? Look up the dictionary. Features. Here came the features. Where did it come? Can you see? I can't see right now. No, it has not been given in the poem, I believe. You can see it in the dictionary. Features means the shape and size of each and every organ on the face is known as feature. What are different kinds of features of people we come across in the world? The shape of our eyes, the position of our eyes, the eyebrows, the forehead, the nose, the lips, the mouth, the chin, all these come under features. Now we have been given the fun time. Look at your friend's face and describe what you see. Use words like wrong. Some people have long face, some have round, some have oval, some have slanted, sharp, flat. All these have been used to describe the features on the face of a person. What is your favorite fruit? Describe it in 5 sentences. Now this is summer season. You can describe mango or any other fruit of your choice. You can use these things. How does it smell? How does it look? Mango smells sweet. It looks yellow in color. How does it feel? It feels too yum, too good. When you bite it, what sound does it make? It makes the sound of plop. How does it taste? It tastes sweet. Now there has been given a breathing exercise. Close your right nostril with your right thumb. Inhale slowly. Now close your right nostril. Inhale slowly through your left nostril till your lungs are filled with air. Now close your left nostril with your second and third fingers. Remove your finger from the right nostril. Exhale through it. Repeat this exercise slowly in the beginning and with practice, and then increase your speed. All these way out have been given here. The way things have been described here. This is a very good breathing exercise. It increases your concentration. Your stress goes out and you feel good. Now this is our let's write section. Do you know a fish breathes from its gills? Write 2 sentences about other animals which can breathe underwater. You have to write about 2 animals which can breathe underwater. The marine animals, all those marine animals, they breathe underwater. Through internet, you will take care of this. You will try to know which animals breathe underwater. Because when I come back to you, I'll ask you. Punctuate the following passage. Now, for the punctuation, the very first thing that we need to keep in mind is the very first letter should be capital. And there should be this thing, commas, apostrophes, and inverted commas, exclamation sign put at a proper place. When I come back to you, I'll tell you what to do, how to do it. Using a red pencil, you have to write down, I like or I do not like the smell of all these things. Among these things, you can use the words. And let me tell you, this is related to your EVS also, super senses. In your same class, this lesson 1 of your EVS book has also this exercise. You like the smell of and you don't like the smell of certain things, right? So this way you have to complete your this poem. Here, when I go to this punctuation part again, mother, capital, comma, father, comma, Neelam. Mother, father, Neelam said, comma, inverted commas, I've got a fire engine. Exclamation, I apostrophe V-E, I've got a fire engine. first up, what's me, what apostrophe s, what's this, question mark, what's again, what apostrophe s, what's this, question mark, inverted commas closed. Here also, inverted commas had to be closed and then begin from here. Call mother, somewhat confused by the noise, comma, inverted commas, I've got a fire engine, exclamation, mother, comma, come and see it, full stop. So now read this chapter, read this poem, enjoy this poem, sing this poem. All the best.